Afternoon and welcome. President Paul Biya has signed a decree reorganizing the General Certificate of Education GCE Board, reducing it to a parastatal. The decree that repeals the administrative running and organization of examinations organized by the GCE Board has started causing fireworks within the trade unions. What does the decree signed on October 22nd add or deduct from the General Certificate of Education Board? Details with our staff lady, Vanessa Mafokeng.
Henceforth, the registrar of the GCE board shall wield the same powers as a general manager of a state corporation. He shall be appointed by the head of state for a period of 3 years, renewable once. He shall be assisted by one deputy registrar rather than two, as was formerly the case, with the rank of deputy general manager. He too shall be appointed by a presidential decree and called assistant registrar as per the Anglo-Saxon culture. Looking at the general structure of the board, its council, formerly composed of 17 members, shall henceforth be known as the board of directors, with only 7 members, including a staff representative. All representations of missionary schools and parents' associations have been suppressed. All members shall be chosen by the head of state for a mandate of 3 years, renewable once. As concerns the organization of examinations, the October 22nd presidential decree suppresses the GCE technical, foreign examinations, baccalaureate technique, and related examinations in English. The same decree, however, introduces new examinations in technical education, such as technical and vocational education examination. Shortly after the release of the decree restructuring the GCE board, trade unionists and other actors in the English subsystem of education have started predicting disastrous days for the subsystem of education. Afu Stephen is a representative of the Presbyterian Education Authority Teachers Trade Union.
This one now is something that is going to be proven. It is a very, very big error that is being made on the part of the government, because the text putting in place is standard. And anything out of it now will not actually work in the right direction for that organization. We will be doing it, but we cannot accept it. That one is okay.
The registrar of the GCE board, Dan Aku Dominic, reacting on the recent decree, lauded it as a giant stride at improving the English subsystem of education.
Thanks, Vanessa Mafokeng. Together, good afternoon and welcome. President Paul Biya has signed a decree reorganizing the General Certificate of Education GCE board, reducing it to a parastatal. The decree that repeals the administrative running and organization of examinations organized by the GCE board has started causing fireworks within the trade unions. What does the decree signed on October 22nd add or deduct from the General Certificate of Education Board? Details with our staff lady, Vanessa Mafokeng.
Henceforth, the registrar of the GCE board shall wield the same powers as a general manager of a state corporation. He shall be appointed by the head of state for a period of 3 years, renewable once. He shall be assisted by one deputy registrar rather than two, as was formerly the case, with the rank of deputy general manager. He too shall be appointed by a presidential decree and called assistant registrar as per the Anglo-Saxon culture. Looking at the general structure of the board, its council, formerly composed of 17 members, shall henceforth be known as the Board of Directors, with only 7 members, including a staff representative. All representations of missionary schools and parents' associations have been suppressed. All members shall be chosen by the head of state for a mandate of 3 years, renewable once. As concerns the organization of examinations, the October 22nd presidential decree suppresses the GCE technical, foreign examinations, baccalaureate technique, and related examinations in English. The same decree, however, introduces new examinations in technical education, such as technical and vocational education examination. Shortly after the release of the decree restructuring the GCE board, trade unionists and other actors in the English subsystem of education have started predicting disastrous days for the subsystem of education. Afu Stephen is a representative of the Presbyterian Education Authority Teachers Trade Union.
This one now is something that is going to be proven. It is a very, very big error that is being made on the part of the government, because the text putting in place is standard. And anything out of it now will not actually work in the right direction for that organization. We will be doing it, but we cannot accept it. That's why it's okay.
The registrar of the GCE board, Dang Aku Dominic, reacting on the recent decree, lauded it as a giant stride at improving the English subsystem of education.
Thanks, Vanessa Mafokeng. To get